right, we're here at my VermiHut indoor worm bin, and the last time we were in here, we did a little experiment with whole paper towels to see if there's a good way to help the worms kind of devour them quicker and get them turned into castings. We are also going to do a really awesome melon experiment, so go ahead and stick around to when it's time to feed. So let's go ahead and dig right in. First of all, we had a paper towel right on top, and you can see where the feeding zone was. They really took care of business. Now, on the left side here, we filled a paper towel with food, and then we carefully spread it out so that it wasn't covered, so it was just one layer of paper towel touching castings. And on the right side here, we crumpled up the paper towel, and with both of them, we put food inside the paper towel here, and we put it on top. And on those paper towels, and in those paper towels, were tomatoes, some onions, peppers, Brussels sprout leaves, strawberry tops, and a banana peel, I believe, on both. So why don't we come over here first and see how the paper towel did. I'm just going to pull right here because there was a paper towel portion of it laying this way. And then now I'm going to come over here. I don't see any there. And I don't see any over here either. So let's dig inside and see if there's any of that food and see if there's any paper towel down at the very bottom of this. And sure enough, I don't see any of the paper towel. So I think that really worked. What we did get is a bit of a worm ball right here, a really tiny worm ball. Not sure if there's food at the center of that or what, but we'll set that to the side. And let's see if there's anything of use down here. It looks like that mango seed portion that's all the way inside, the cotyledon, is right there. Here we've got a little bit of a pumpkin stem. And in here, okay, it looks like a little bit of the tomato and the banana stalk. So not a whole lot. And it's been 19 days, so I don't expect there to be too much in here. And one of the things that the worms do is they will eat all around the stuff they don't want. And clearly, they did not want this sticker, so we'll take that out. All right, let's go ahead and go over to this other side over here. And this is where we put the food just right on top of the napkin. So we're going to have to go pretty deep to see if we can find any crumpled up napkin. And, or paper towel, I think is what we use. So let me just kind of turn it over. Of course, I'm not finding any paper towel at all on either side. I guess I needed to come in here quicker, but we were on vacation and out of town, so that's why you haven't seen a whole lot of me recently. But oh my gosh, I'm trying to think if there's any portion whatsoever in here. Nope. It looks like they just like those paper towels. Of course, when I'm trying to do an experiment, they eat both of them. But when I'm just trying to run a regular worm bin, then I have all kinds of leftover matted down napkins. This might be the remnants of something, or it could have come from there. So looks like this worm, these worms in this worm bin love our paper towels. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and aerate this, and then we are going to set up for our top feeding experiment. I'm really excited about this one. All right, here's that mango. Let's see if they've gotten everything out of it. Pretty much. I know we found the cotyledon earlier, but sometimes they like to hide in there. So there's a few, not quite as much as we had last time, but good showing within there. One of the things I want to show you is when I feed in a certain zone and then I come back when they're still feeding on it, I mostly find all the worms right down the center. But here I have pulled from the sides and there's all kinds of worms in it. So what ends up happening is the worms will swarm kind of towards where you put the food. And then when they've taken care of it, they're going to go back out throughout the bin and they're just going to take care of all the food bits and pieces that are all over the bin. So if you ever find your worms in good clumps and worm balls, that kind of thing, attacking food, and then one time you come in and they are all spread out, don't worry too much. There is nothing wrong with your bin. They have just consumed all the food and they are spreading out and getting all the other stuff that they can eat within the bin. So spread out worms is kind of an indicator that you could probably feed a little bit more at your next feeding. So the first thing we're going to do before we start the experiment is I'm just going to kind of bury all the old stuff that I found here real quick. So I'm going to keep trying to get rid of our paper towel. So I'll put that in there, and then we will put our old food stuff within here also. And then why not? Let's give them a little bit of worm chow in there, and then some coffee grounds, and then some grit as well. All right, that's our little secret feeding of all the old stuff. Now I'm just going to kind of get this all set. It's really high because I basically fluffed it up, so I'm going to try and get it nice and even here for us and compact it down. So here are the three different kinds of melons that we are going to be putting in the bin. We've got some cantaloupe, some watermelon, and some pumpkin. And I want to thank one of the commenters that asked me if I could redo an experiment that I had done years ago, which was kind of winter or fall fruit versus summer fruit. And that was the pumpkin versus the watermelon. So I'm going to add in one more thing, cantaloupe here. So let's put in another one there and then another one here. And very unscientific here. I'm not going to put the same weights or the same sizes. This is just what I had. So what I think will be interesting is which one they come to first, along with which one they devour first. And I'm going to try and put them in all different kinds of ways here just to see if there's any difference in how they attack it. So put a good chunk right there. And maybe this one will be up like that, just to try and get them, you know, a quicker access to the melon, that kind of thing. I think I'm going to move this, because the other experiment I wanted to do was, now that we're going to have the worms up on the top surface, why don't we put a little bit of our amendments to see how quickly they go for those as well. So we'll put some worm chow right there. Then let's put some of our coffee right about here. Spread that, see if they attack that all at once. And then I'm even going to put some pulverized eggshell grit and see if they come up here and kind of take it for themselves. All right, so check this out. This, I hope, is going to be really cool. I'm pretty excited about it. So, you know what? Why don't we take a couple days look at this and see how it's doing so far. Cool. So I'm going to continue to film this for about a minute each day, and then I'll string together the whole time lapse, and we'll be able to see which melon they go for and kind of what they do with the different amendments that we have in here. So hope you're all having a great day. I hope your worm bins are doing fantastic. So happy vermicomposting, everybody. Take care now.